If you had been following the news, you would have heard and seen in October, our brothers and sisters in Mexico suffered a couple of very powerful earthquakes in the southern area of Chiapas and Oaxaca. And in a beautiful way, many groups throughout the country responded with collections of money and non-perishable material, medical supplies to go down. There was lots and lots of ads on the TV and the radio and the news. Lots of energy around all this throughout our town and throughout the country. In the midst of that, all the vinyl fell off my both car doors. And so my administrative assistant said, you know, there's a guy who does great upholstery work down the street. And so I finally found a little time and went down. I met a wonderful young man named Mario. So as he looked over our doors and explained what he was going to be able to do, he looked up to me and he said, Fry, what the address is down in Mexico, he said, what do you think of all this media rush around the earthquakes? And I said, well, seems like they're trying to respond and help people out. He said, you know, I'm kind of a bit skeptical. These groups oftentimes disappear when there's a disaster and we don't hear from them anymore. He said, but you guys at Casa Franciscan, I see you every day, day in and day out. People come to you for food. People come to you for medical care. People come to your social workers and they help them out. You don't toot your horn, you don't do any publicity, but you're doing it every single day, and I respect you. Well, it was a bit of a surprise because all of this was unsolicited. I just wanted to get my upholstery done on my doors, and this guy responded this way. But it gave me a lot to think and pray about as the days went on. As we moved into November, we're trying to see how we can better serve the communities that live around us, and so we spent a couple days doing interviews in our neighborhood of about 400 people when it was all said and done. And I had a chance to be involved in those interviews. So as we went up to people's porches on Saturday morning and talked to them, our first question on the report was, have you heard of Casa Franciscana? And without exception, they all smiled. And they said, yes. And we said, have you benefited from any of the services of Casa Franciscana? And some said no, but most said yes. Some received grocery bags, some have come to our clinic to receive help. Some have bought materials from our women's cooperative, whatever. But it was a very warm and generous response. It's oftentimes if you go to someone's front door and, you know, you're wearing a brown robe and people don't really know what's going on, it's kind of stay away. But people, just the opposite, were delighted to converse with us and to share how our services had blessed them. I lay that out to you because we hear that key word, authority, twice in the Gospel of Mark today. And it's a word that we see throughout the Gospels. And if you go to your Greek New Testament dictionary, you know, this word exousia has all kinds of different explanations because it's such a powerful expression. And you can't just grab it with one word. But my sense is, which is really important for us today as we hear this text, is that Jesus has authority because what he teaches, he then lives out. And people see that constantly. They get a lot of teaching from the scribes and Pharisees, but they don't see a lot of action. Jesus speaks about a God of compassion, and he reaches out in compassion consistently to people. He talks about a God who loves the poor, and he spends 3 years of his life walking and blessing and honoring the poor. That is authority. What people hear about the blessings of God, he put into action. We have a sense of that authority too. One of my favorite people in the whole world is Pope Francis because he has authority. Pope Francis talks constantly about the compassion of God, and if you saw the news clip, a policeman got knocked off the horse. There was an accident. He's going through this motorcade in Chile, and he stops. The driver gets down and goes and reaches out and cares for that person. He preaches compassion, and he responds with compassion. His message that we hear time and time again is that we're all brothers and sisters because we're all sons and daughters of God, and therefore Pope Francis washes the feet of a Muslim woman on Holy Thursday night. That's authority. I think you have a sense of that. So as I had this dialogue with different people in our neighborhood, and that's this positive response came out. I was grateful. I've only been working this job for a year and a half, but friars and so many volunteers and workers of Casa Franciscana had gone before me since 1967 have proclaimed the compassion of God and to be followers of St. Francis of Assisi, and people experience that every day. So over time, we have some wonderful authority in our community to reach out and to touch people. And we're blessed to have support of wonderful people like you and people from all over the country who support us. Your faith, your prayers, and your generosity and your support gives us this authority to reach out and to touch these people. And it's a great and tremendous gift. We know in our Christian journey and in spirituality, we need to, in a certain sense, give authority to Jesus for him to come in and bless us, and then we can bless others. And so many people in this community have done that for so many years, and we are always deeply grateful, and so grateful to come each year and to thank you for you supporting us and giving us authority to be gospel people and Franciscan people in the area where we serve. But we've come back, so we come back and appreciate that support. Many of you don't know what we're doing, but we are a Franciscan mission now down in Guaymas, started in 1967. We now kind of grown to 23 employees. We have a place where we serve hot meals twice a day, breakfast and lunch, to about 500 to 600 people. Some of that food is driven up into the neighborhoods where people aren't able to come down and get a meal. Many people are shut-ins or elderly who can't get out, so food is taken to them. We have a full-time nurse. We have many volunteers, doctors, and dentists that come and help her out to receive people. She goes with us into the neighborhoods, sometimes to deliver the food bags for people who can't get out, groceries they receive. We offer people communion who are shut-ins, and she takes the pleasure and cares for them. We have lots of daily services and lots of special missions that we do as well. Brother Bob, as I mentioned, is a part of our medical mission we do each year. Franciscan friars or medical professionals come down and invite doctors and dentists and other medical people from our area. We don't draw people so much from the state, but we like to animate the local medical professionals. This year, we went to two different villages and spent 2 days in each of these villages, and when it was all said and done, we had served 991 people. And almost all of that medical service was free. Doctors and dentists from the area who came to help us. All kinds of incredible things going on. We have a women's cooperative. You see their wonderful goods, local material from our area that they're selling. We have a culinary school. Also, these two programs not only just give people direct aid, but a chance to move ahead in their life, to do something different, to be creative, and to get better jobs and increase income in their families. I could spend all day talking about the wonderful place where I work and the wonderful people who are involved in it, but really I want to say there's miracles happening every day. Because we now, both with the great work of Casa Franciscana over many years, we have authority in the community and people respond to it. And a big part of the authority comes from the support and the wonderful, generous prayers and reaching out. People have come even from Scottsdale and from Phoenix to come down to work on our buildings and paint. We have service missions and different things you all can do. So we're so grateful for that. But we want to keep going, so we continue to need your help. So you can go out, look for all the people in those wonderful orange vests, and they're happy to take your donations. We take checks, any major credit cards, and we're happy to receive any cash you want to offer, and we're not shy about receiving $100 bills. It's not a problem at all for us. You don't have to be shy. But please come and join us. Raquel, who's singing, is a product of Brother Ivo's mariachi school, which is much younger. Her husband, Jesus, is on our board, so they're offering wonderful Mexican music as you go out today. So come and join us. It's always a delight to be with you. Thank you for this opportunity, and may God bless you all.